To investigate shadows in Revit, let's start with our unit classroom. In the Graphics Display options, open the Sun Setting dialog. Choose the Still option and open the Location dialog to set the location to Detroit. After selecting OK, we can now turn on shadows and turn on the sun path. The sun path displays the sun at a specific date and time. We can move the sun, or we can manually enter a new date and time. When making these changes, notice the different shadows that are projected throughout the day and year. Looking at a section view, we can see the shadows in the classroom on a December afternoon. The sun is low, so the lighting is soft, and the shadows are long. Now let's change the date to July. Now we have a more intense sun, which is less desirable. In order to promote winter daylight and shade summer light, we can do multiple things. Let us start by editing the roof. Select the roof and edit its footprint. Select the boundary line and extend the overhang to promote summer shading. Notice that we have blocked out part of the light. Let's repeat this process until we are satisfied. To block out more light, we can also add architectural shading devices. By creating a new floor footprint and moving it into place, let's make a shading device that will block out the rest of the sun. In a 3D view, we will notice that the new shading device has blocked out the remainder of our summer sun. Now, we have created a model that is shaded in the summer but bright in the winter. Let's save our model and export it as a GBXML. When finished, we can import the file into GBS in order to run the analysis. After the analysis is finished, we can select the project and compare the two runs. Overall, our edited building has a cheaper total annual energy cost.